أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Brothers and sisters, my brothers and sisters, very very important topic a lot to speak about is envy and jealousy. Now my brothers and sisters, this sin is so severe and it's so deadly, and the consequences behind it and what it can lead to is also deadly and very very serious, my brothers and sisters, because a lot of people today in our ummah are suffering with the jealousy and envy today, and a lot of it drives a lot of us and it causes us to even sin. And you need to understand the origins of jealousy, my brothers and sisters. Believe it or not, and there's going to be a lot of people that's going to argue about this, but believe it or not, the very, very first sin ever committed was jealousy. It wasn't disobeying Allah Azza wa Jal. Because when Allah told Shaitan, prostrate to Adam, and he refused, he said, "Inta khalaqtani min nar wa huwa min teen," translated, "You made me from fire and him from clay. I'm better than him." He had tukabbur, he had arrogance. But before he disobeyed Allah and didn't prostrate to Adam alayhi salam, he had jealousy in his heart for Adam, because he saw what Adam, the glory Adam was given when he was born. He saw when Allah Azza wa Jal told the angels to prostrate, and Shaitan was angry and jealous. Shaitan was saying, "I have been worshipping you, Ya Allah, and look at the glory that Adam gets, alayhi salam." So before he disobeyed Allah Azza wa Jal, Shaitan had jealousy in his heart. He was jealous of Adam. Then he disobeyed Allah Azza wa Jal. Then he said, "I am made of fire and him from clay, and I am better than him." He had tukabbur in his heart. And this is what cursed Shaitan. This is what cursed Shaitan to eternal life in the hellfire. So the very, very first sin, my brothers and sisters, you need to understand, look what led to disobedience. It was jealousy. He was jealous of Adam alayhi salam. And today, my brothers and sisters, our ummah, we're suffering with this, and it's leading to more sins. I've seen people I've known for over 15 years, I've seen the jealousy in their eyes. I've seen family members, parents' jealousy. I've seen other scenarios of people where the father couldn't even sit in his own son's restaurant because his son had a restaurant. Allah blessed him with a restaurant. He goes, "I cannot even sit in this restaurant." His own blood, I've seen jealousy, my brothers and sisters. I've heard stories. Today, my brothers and sisters, it's so easy. I can be anywhere around the world. I post one picture. Wherever I am, thousands, millions worldwide can see where I am. Jealousy, straight away. And then it can even lead to the end, the evil eye. And then we say, "Why do I have the evil eye?" And then we run to the Mashiach. We're saying, "We have the evil eye. This is happening to us. That's happening to us." When we ourselves, we want to be glorified. We want to show off. It's in our nature. If something, look, today I can't even eat a plate of spaghetti without taking a picture and showing the whole world. We want to show off. It's in our nature. We like the recognition. We want that like button. We want that love button. We want fame. This is what insan has become. So my brothers and sisters, it is very, very dangerous. It's a very deadly sin. It burns your good deed like firewood burns when you're jealous. Wallahi, my brothers and sisters, alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Till this day, those that know me, every time I speak to them, every time I see them succeed, every time they, whatever they do in life, my response is, Tabarakallah, Barakallahu Feek. May Allah bless and protect you, my brother. And I think I'm in a different planet today, because no one ever, till this day, says this to anyone anymore. Brother had a baby. I never hear from anyone. brothers succeeded that job, someone got a promotion, someone bought a new car. These words don't come out of anyone's mouth anymore. Tabarakallah, it doesn't even come out of anyone's mouth anymore. Barakallahu fiqh, it does not come out of anyone's mouth anymore. A lot of responses are silence and they're burning inside. They can't swallow it. Why? Why can't you be happy for your brothers and sisters? Why? Why can't you say, Ya Rab, give them more? Because you know something, my brothers and sisters, when you make dua for your brothers and sisters, when you say, Ya Rab, give my brother, give my sister, the angels, they make dua for you and they say, and you too. But today, it's all competition. It's all who's gonna win the race. It's all who's got more money, who's more successful, who's got the new car, who's got the new boat. We're cutting each other's throat. No one's happy for anyone. And then we're calling each other brothers and sisters. After what? After what are we brothers and sisters? This is not Muslims. We are not Muslims if we're acting this way, my brothers and sisters. Be happy for your brother. Be happy for your sister. Pray for them. Make dua for them. Say, Ya Rab, give them barakah in their lives. We need to get rid of this satanic behavior, this jealousy, this envy, this hatred that's in our heart, because it's poison and it will destroy the ummah, just like it destroyed shaitan. Because shaitan, he had jealousy in his heart. The very first sin committed was jealousy. My brothers and sisters, a real Muslim, a real Muslim. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, none of you, listen to what he's saying, listen to your Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, none of you will be real Muslims, real believers, until he wishes for himself what he wishes for his brothers and sisters. So the good that you wish for yourself, you wish it for your brothers and sisters. None of you, he's saying, none of you will be real Muslims, real mu'mins, until you wish for what you wish for yourself upon your Muslim brothers and sisters. But today, nah, that's not the case today. Today, ba'id the shar, I can't even post a picture of myself anywhere, because I know my brothers and sisters are not going to be happy. There's going to be someone sitting there biting his lips. Not that I have any intention of posting, but this is the example I'm trying to give you. Because this is the heart that a lot of brothers and sisters today have. Jealousy. So my brothers and sisters, we need to change. We, listen to the key word, we, and I'm including myself in this because I'm a humble Muslim. We need to change. We need to start making dua for one another, wishing well for one another. We need to start making dua, Ya Allah, give him, give her, give barakah. And my brothers and sisters, you'll see a big, big change. The angels, they say, when you're making dua for your brothers and sisters, in no matter what circumstances it is, whether it's health, wealth, barakah, sickness, doesn't matter what, the angels say, and you too. Imagine the angels, they're saying, and you too. The angels are making dua for you because you're doing a selfless act. We need to get rid of this poison that's in our hearts, this competition that's in our hearts. We shouldn't be competing with one another, my brothers and sisters. We should be encouraging one another. We should be the stepladder for one another. A real Muslim, listen to your Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam. A real Muslim, a real believer, what he wishes for himself, he wishes the good for himself, he wishes it for his brothers and sisters. This is a real Muslim. My brothers and sisters, when you say something that your brother and sister has, when you say something good happening for them, Tabarakallah, Allahumma barik. This is the response. This is the response you have to give one another. And my brothers and sisters, again, our Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam, what did our Prophet Yaqub say to him? He says, do not convey your dream to your brothers. He had a dream. The dream was interpreted that he was going to become a big prophet. His father Yaqub knew. His blood brothers, forget mates, forget my kawi, forget I've known him for 20 years. His brothers, the Prophet said, do not convey your dream to your brothers. Why? Because they will become jealous. And once they found out, what did they do? Out of jealousy, out of anger, look where it leads, look how one thing can lead to another. They threw him down the well. They plotted to knock the guy. They plotted to kill him, their own brother, out of jealousy. Look how severe and deadly this sin is. So the moral of this story is, my brothers and sisters, we need to stop publicizing everything. He eats a plate of food, he drinks something, he buys a new car, he's somewhere here, he's somewhere there. Chick, 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 and he wants the likes. He can't go, one day he can't sleep without the likes. Everything is social media, you have to show everyone everything. Because we want the acknowledgement. No one wants to admit it. Nah, not my cars, but he's posting every single fish that he caught. He wants that, he wants the acknowledgement. Nah, not my brother, but he's somewhere on holidays, he's wearing his sunnies and he's taking photos with the family. My brothers and sisters, I'm telling you, for your own good, for your own protection, you're gonna have someone out there. Mahru albu, he's burning, he'll see these photos, he'll see what you're eating, he'll see where you are, he's doing that tough. You got the aim, you got the evil eye. Don't say why, don't say why. You wanna post everything, you wanna publish everything. That's the consequences. Try to live a private life. Try to live a private life. You ask all the sheikh, they'll be telling you the same thing. I'm not a sheikh. Forget me. I'm nothing. Take my life, take my advice, take it or leave it. But try to live a private life and you have a peaceful one. Try to keep it to yourselves, my brothers and sisters. I'm telling you this for your own good, for your own sake. Stop trying to publish every single thing you do today. I ask Allah Azza wa Jal to guide us, to protect us, to forgive us, to have mercy on us, and to protect this Muslim Ummah, to give us the knowledge, to give us the discipline, because that's what we're lacking today, discipline. It's easy to know something, but it's more harder to put into effect. To put that discipline in our lives, and to protect us from the ayan, and to give us that knowledge to learn, and to love one another instead of competing with one another and being jealous of one another. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.